Hello everyone, my name is Ria, and in this video I'm going to explain you how to construct a collaboration diagram for a given application. So the application that has been assigned to us is online exam registration. So first of all, let me tell you what is collaboration diagram. It is basically a description of interacting behaviors between collection of objects. This behavior is partly derived from the static relationships defined in the class diagram. And subclasses may have an interacting behavior that is different from the same behavior of a superclass. Due to redefinition of methods in subclasses, and we have some examples of collaborations such as ATM system, inventory system, post registration system, and investment record system. So now let's see how the collaboration diagram is constructed. So I've already constructed the collaboration diagram over here. So it's very easy to construct a collaboration diagram. It's just that we need to have a sequence diagram first, and there's an option for converting the sequence diagram into collaboration diagram. So as you're all seeing it, it is arranged in a square form, but actually when the sequence diagram is converted to collaboration diagram, it's not in this form, so it will all be in a jumbled format. So you need to without displacing your information about each and every sequence, you have to place the objects in such a way that it comes in a square format. So here the student is connected to the exam website, then the exam website is connected to the web server, exam website is also connected to the admin, and the web server is connected to the admin, and the admin is connected to the database. So it's just same as the sequence diagram, it's just that the representation becomes different. So in the student, you can all see first it clicks on the register tab, and then the exam website sends the it displays the register field, and then the student has to enter the information. It is just same as the sequence of steps that we saw in the sequence diagram. So then after the student enters the information, it clicks on the submit button, and if the web server checks the information of the student is valid or not. If it is invalid, the student is asked to re-enter the information, and when it is valid, the student receives a acceptance mail. So after that, the student has to log in order to view the question paper. So after, if the login is unsuccessful, the student has to re-log in, and if the login is successful, the question paper is displayed and the student starts answering it. So after answering it, the student submits the question paper, and the answers are verified, and it is sent back to the exam website after the total score is calculated and the score of the student is displayed. So that's all for the collaboration diagram. Thanks for watching this video.